face. She eat me up, she got expensive taste. I see you dreaming, but you're still awake. Big slices, that's how you cut the cake. It's cold as hell, I show and tell.
Alright, hey guys, OPA Junior Bodybuilder Spencer Moore here. I just finished my first workout back from after my competition. I worked chest today, so just kind of like an ego-boosting workout, really. I just did some flat presses, some flies, incline hammer strength, some dips to finish off, that sort of thing. Just a basic workout to get the blood flowing, good pump. What I'm going to talk about today is creatine. So a lot of people think, are asking me, what is creatine? What does it do? Why should I take it? Let's start off with what it's made up of. So creatine is made up of three amino acids, arginine, methionine, and glycine. The reason why I think creatine works well is because, in my opinion, muscle growth is a result of the hydration of that muscle. So when you're getting a good pump in the gym, that will hydrate and volumize the muscle fibers, which stretches the fascia, leads to growth, right? So the fascia surrounds the muscle, it's got to expand to allow the muscle to grow, right? The increased blood flow around the muscle will also spark protein synthesis of the actin and myosin, which are the two proteins in your myofibrils, which are going to increase the size of your muscle cells. Increased strength can also only take place in a hydrated muscle. So because when you're dehydrated, the blood volume decreases, and when blood volume decreases, the muscle cell strength will suffer. It has a decreased ability to push further into a set, but like a hydrated muscle fiber, the strength will be there, speeds recovery between the sets, etc. And we all know that creatine helps hydrate muscle. You know, that's why people have water retention with creatine monohydrate, just the extra water is there. And when your muscle is pumped and hydrated, you get better oxygen delivery to the muscle. Which is also good. I mean, the pump and creatine work together, so that's why you see a lot of pre-workouts where they have like a nitric oxide booster like arginine or citrulline, and they mix it with creatine. So you're getting the hydration and the pump factor. Creatine is also a major storage form of fuel that drives muscular contractions. So when you're lifting heavy weights, and you have used the creatine stores that your muscles have in them, those need to be regenerated before further contractions can take place. So by having that creatine readily available in your body, your muscles or your body will pull that from your digestive tract and fuel it to your muscles. So creatine is also beneficial to take post-workout. As you have 45 minutes after your workout to flood your muscles with growth promoting nutrients. That's what they call the anabolic window or the nutrient delivery window, where you have that time frame after your workout where you still have a pump. And so when you put your proteins, it's going to break down to the amino acids, your simple carbs, which is going to break down into simpler strands, glycogen. In that 45 minutes, your body will pull these nutrients from your digestive tract, and the pump will actually help with the blood transport to the muscle you just worked and pull around the muscle tissues to feed them. So that's, in my opinion, why creatine works and why it's good. Again, if you have any other questions, email me. It's in the intro slideshow to the video, spendingathletics.com. If you have anything else you want me to cover in videos, email me, send me a shout, diets, workouts, etc. I'll try and fit in my video as soon as possible. Thanks for watching this vlog. Keep coming back and watching more. I really appreciate the support, guys. Have a good one.